Hello, everybody. I'm glad you're here today. Today is March 11th, 2024. I am bringing you a word at the end of this video from March 8th, 2024. It's a heavy word. Not gonna lie, y'all. Just telling you right now. It's got some graphic descriptions in it that I would not come up with things like that. That to me, when I hear from the Lord, when I'm worshiping, and there are words and phrases used that I would not come up with myself, that's how it feels, very confirming and affirming that the Lord is actually saying these things to me that are divinely inspired, is how I would describe them. You need to just pray in the Holy Spirit and ask God what He wants you to glean from whatever I bring you in this video. Now then, over the last couple of days, I was thinking, I need to make a video. I don't have much to say. I don't have anything to say. And the Lord kept speaking to me these words: remember whose you are. Remember whose you are. All right. So now, when my kids would leave, when they were in high school or junior high, and they'd go out with their friends or go over to somebody's house, maybe you do this, maybe your parents did this. I don't know. Y'all comment below and tell me what as they're leaving the door, as they're going out the door, you say, "Remember whose you are," and make sure you're back in time before curfew. So that's what we would do, and what that meant was, we didn't mean remember whose you are, like our reputation was at stake, Mike and mine's. That's not what we meant at all. What we meant was, you belong to the King. So don't forget that while you're out and about in the world doing your bowling or your ice cream making or whatever you're doing. Make sure you remember whose you are. And so I want to just bring that thought to you today, because you and I are people of great value. And the only thing that makes us valuable is that we belong to the King, that we are children of God. Everything else that we think gives us value in life is literally garage sale stuff, compared to being a child of God. All right, so that's what I want you to hang on to more than anything else. And so as I bring you this word that's kind of heavy, just at the very end of it, and the Lord reiterates this, we are children of the King, and we are in the love of the Father. If you believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God and are following Him because you love Him, not out of obligation, rooted in love, that's your motivation for following Jesus and patterning your life after His. All right? So those are the thoughts that are running over my mind and through my mind the last couple of days, is remember whose you are. And that's a good thought. That's a good thought. So I want to read out of Psalms 146. This is the New Living Translation, y'all. It's like the Redneck Bible, all right? It's just words I can understand better. That's what I read from. If there's a translation you're digging, just stick with it and roll with it. This is the one I'm digging right now. And I used to do New International Version, and I'd still go to that. That's kind of my checker version. But then I also have a husband that knows Greek and Hebrew because he's got his master's in New Testament. So, yeah, that comes in handy too. But this, as we remember that we are of value because God makes us valuable. He is the Creator, we are the created, and we submit ourselves to Him to mold us into whatever He wants us to be, to His purpose and His glory. That's why we're here on earth, y'all. And we're here for such time as this. The Lord could have put me anywhere in the timeline of the world. He could have put me in ancient Egypt. He could have put me in World War I. He could have put me anywhere, but He put me now. He put me in World War III. That's what it feels like now. So what that we're here, and you too. He has a plan and good works for you planned also. So we are all here for a purpose for such a time as this. So as we move forward through this video, I want to bring this word to you, this scripture to you. Psalms 146. Praise the Lord. Let all that I am praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. Yes. I will sing praises to my God with my dying breath. Y'all, I make up songs to God sometimes. I make up words just singing when I'm by myself. Not when anybody can hear me, but that's just me being me. But yeah. Don't put your confidence in powerful people. There is no help for you there. Oh, wait a minute. Do we vote? Yes, we do. I wonder if that's what this maybe applies to. Could, I guess. When they breathe their last, they return to the earth and all their plans die with them. But joyful are those who have the God of Israel as their helper, whose hope is in the Lord, their God. That's us. We're the joyful ones. He made heaven and earth, the seas and everything in them. He keeps every promise forever. He gives justice to the oppressed and food to the hungry. The Lord frees the prisoners. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are weighed down. Raise your hand if you're weighed down. Dang, at this moment, when I go to the grocery store, I'm pretty weighed down when I come out. But I know there are other life situations that are far heavier than where I'm at this moment. Now, it's only a matter of time before I get weighed down with the next crisis. But the Lord lifts us up. The Lord lifts up those who are weighed down. The Lord loves the godly. The Lord protects the foreigners among us. He cares for the orphans and the widows. But he frustrates the plans of the wicked. The Lord will reign forever. He will be your God. Yes, he will. Yes, he is. And we need to hang on to that truth as we just move forward through life, through these weird times. Things are still moving very quickly. Now, granted, I don't feel like there's a big shockwave that I'm enduring or riding out at the moment. What do you think? On the worldwide stage? But I do think another one's coming because the Lord said labor pains. And once labor pains start, y'all, they don't just magically quit till the baby's born. All right. March 8th, 2024. This is what I wrote in my journal after I worshipped Father. I get up at like at 4, and the rest of my family gets up around 6. So sometimes my husband gets up at 5:30, but that's how we roll, and that's when I have my quiet time. I get up early and worship every morning. And sometimes he talks to me. And when he does, I write this down. You do with what you want to with this, all right? But these are some graphic phrases. Child, hear what I am about to say. The shores of your nation are littered with corpses of infants. Piled high on your nation's mountains lie the corpses of lost souls led astray by your nation's agenda. See clearly, my children, the Lord in which you dwell is... Back up. Let me say that again. See clearly, my children, the land in which you dwell is not of me. But you, my children, are of me. You live among these walking corpses who know me not, but you are the live ones. I in you am life. The putrid smell of rotting hearts, the evil at hand, strikes and kills all who do not choose me. In the coming hours, H-O-U-R-S, in the coming hours, your nation will turn against me, having no idea what it is doing. Evil is at hand in your White House. So evil, so rotted, even death winces as he watches his future victims. You cannot conceive of this evil, in all capitals. But I warn you now, this evil is about to be unleashed upon all in this land. And I said, Father, I'm still listening. Is there any more? I wrote that down. And this is what I heard him say. At this moment, you are unaware of the evil plotting against you. You will not connect these dots, for they are not seen. Do not spend your time figuring out what you are baffled about. You cannot piece together this puzzle. Many sense this coming. Something is coming, you say, for I have nudged you in your spirit to feel this something. And that's correct. It is not coming. It is here already, being fed, growing, about to be unlocked, like a wild dog unleashed. So will this be. When the cell door is unlocked, you will be. And then if you will just see that. I don't even know what he said. I don't even know that there's a human word for it. Or if there is, I wasn't meant to hear it. I am the way, the truth, the life. I am your way through the coming. Once again, I did not hear. It's like an unspeakable. I guess. You tell me what you think. Faith, my beautiful children, faith and love, let me feed you now to make you healthy. Let me pour my peace upon you now while quiet lay on your land. Sit with me now and learn my voice. Stand with me now and learn my strength. Walk with me now and learn my joy. Run with me now and learn my power. When you hear yourself saying, "What just happened?" then you will know the evil which has been under lock and key is being opened. Do not despair. Look at me, for I will be the only certainty. And that was it. I mean, to me, that's pretty heavy stuff. And I know we can laugh and have a good time on this channel, but this particular word was meant to be kind of, I mean, it's a warning. It's a warning, y'all. And we have to, you need to do whatever you need to do to respond to that. If you don't know Jesus, you need to believe in him and follow. Okay? That being said, I mean, I don't want to beat a dead horse, but that's the truth. I would just probably, I was just at my parents' while ago, and really, if you were to sum up our conversation, our nation's in a real big mess right now, as is everything that rebels against God. And since our nation is so full of pride, we are very proud. I mean, the land of the free and the brave, and we're very proud, the United States is, very independent and somewhat rebellious. We founded our nation on rebellion. Our nation is founded on rebelling against someone else and our independence. That's our DNA. All right? That's what I've learned. And I've been around people from other countries, not just Mexico. Of course, Mexico for sure, because I live in Texas. But we have businesses. We have a business that put us in contact with people from Norway, Denmark, Japan, Poland, all kinds of places. And we went to those countries. I stayed home with the kids, but my husband, my parents went because it was a family business. And one of the things that I came away from that experience, when you become so close to people from Europe, and those of you from Europe, please tell me, am I hitting the target at all here? Is each group of people from each nation has a different kind of national DNA within them. They speak of things in their context. In the United States, we are so blessed and so wealthy that we and so prideful. And those are elements that the Lord is like, yeah, pride goeth before a fall. And humble yourself in the sight of the Lord and he will lift you up. Those are teachings from our Lord. And I'm not sure our country's like walking in that right now. When I look, I'm going back to the Europeans that we worked with, their view of World War II was very different than ours. Very different. Much more serious. I can't say that word online. Okay, so their concept of the leader in Germany is they don't joke about that. They don't joke about him. I know Americans kind of can do it lightly. We made that mistake one time, and they didn't laugh. It was actually a Seinfeld reference about the soup. I'm not allowed to say it on YouTube. The soup line guy. You remember where Seinfeld, Jerry and all them went to buy soup, and that soup guy would not let them, not let everybody buy the soup. You remember that? Remember what they called him? So we were joking about that one time in front of our friends from Europe, and they weren't laughing because their DNA about World War II is much more severe and tragic than America's. America, the closest in my lifetime we've ever come to any kind of threat like that has been 9/11. And I know y'all all remember that day, and I know, or many of you do. And I don't want to, you know, refer to it all the time, but one of the things I remember was not knowing what was going to happen next. The sense of vulnerability was tremendous. And waiting for the other shoe to drop kind of feel. And not fully comprehending the tragedy until a while later. What? I can remember they had triage stations set up. And nobody was being treated in the triage stations because there weren't survivors. And when I remember seeing that, I thought, oh, I don't understand this. I don't understand the magnitude of this. Whatever is coming, it may be in slow increments, y'all. It may be death by a thousand cuts. It may be one big thing. I don't know. But what I do know is, our Lord is the only one who is constant. He is our refuge, our fortress. He will fight for us. Because we are his children. What parent that's listening to this wouldn't die for their child? Of course I would step in front of them and take the bullet. Of course. Without a hesitancy. Wouldn't you? Yes. And we are God's children. And he's perfect in his love. So imagine his mightiness in those promises to us. And those feelings towards us. As his children. So whatever you're going through. And whatever's coming. Just hang on and remember whose you are. Because that's everything. That's all I have, y'all. Pray for each other. If you have a prayer request, put it in the comment section right now. We will pray. Our weapons are prayer and love. pray for us because it's fire. We're in West Texas. I'm in the Texas Panhandle. Fires are like everywhere right now. Smoke, we breathe it in. We're choking up our lungs. We're coughing up lungs all the time because of our air quality. Y'all, we got another round this week of bad wind and dry. So please pray for the safety of the Texas Panhandle. Stay safe, America. Hold the line, Texas. This is Gina Lima Charlie. I'm out.